You're looking for me, and who might you be? My father sent you?
Yeah, to see if you're still alive, and well. I'm Geralt of Rivia.
I'm quite alive and extraordinarily well, Geralt of Rivia. Better than I've ever been in this rotten life of mine, and now that you've seen me, I bid you farewell.
Wait.
We've nothing more to talk about.
Your father's a vile man. You're angry and bitter. Can't blame you.
Why do you help him then? Why did you take this job?
Because he knows something about someone dear to me. Promised to tell me if I found you and your mother.
Got it. A bit of blackmail. Just his style. Well, now you've found me, you can tell him I'm alive and I'm never coming back.
Before I agreed to look for you, your father told me his version of events. Tell me yours.
Mine? It's dull as life amidst the swamps. My earliest memories are of a drunken father lying under the stairs, caked in mud and clutching a bottle. Next dozen years, pretty much the same. Father would drink, disappear for days, then come home in a rage and send furniture flying. Thank the gods for war. I was glad every time they sent him off. And the quarrels. I remember him screaming at Mum, the thuds as he beat her, then her sobbing. I'd hide under my bed and long for silence. That's the long and short of it. Multiply by 19 and there you have my life. Finally, we'd had enough, Mum and me. He crossed the line and we fled.
Wojtek claims your mother had strange marks on her hands and that a monster dragged her into the woods. That true?
We were riding towards the river. Suddenly, Mum cried out, bent over, almost fell off her horse. I rode up to her and saw something strange. Her hands were on fire. And then that creature leapt from the woods. I don't know what it was, but it roared so fierce my nose bled. I saw it topple trees. I've never been so scared in my life. And that thing grabbed my Mum and disappeared into the woods. I wanted to turn back, go after them, but the horses panicked. Now I don't even know if she's alive.
I don't mean to pry, but I know your mother had a miscarriage.
His doing? He shoved her, she fell, that's how it started. We were alone, no one to help, blood everywhere. Worst night of my life.
Sorry. Must have been hard for you both.
Mum was in shock. She was raving that it was better this way, that she never wanted the child. Must have had a fever. She was losing blood the whole time.
She didn't want the child?
Said she'd sooner cut open her gut than bear another child from his seed.
What will you do now?
Find my Mum.
You realize that might not be that easy.
Don't worry, I'm not daft enough to believe I can do it alone. I've got some new friends now. Powerful friends. They'll help me.
Who are these friends, if it's not a secret?
No secret. Heard of the Church of the Eternal Fire? A priest helped me contact the Redanian witch hunters. Righteous, brave men. They'll help me.
Hence the candlesticks in your room. So you believe in the Eternal Fire?
Once the heat of the fire has set your heart aflame, it gives you strength and leads you down the path of truth for the rest of your life. I hope it'll bless you with its warmth one day.
Thanks. Thing is, fire's tricky. It's easy to get burned. What about your father?
Who? Oh, him. I don't care. I won't go back to him. That bit of my life? Forgotten it already.
Well, well. A witcher. Never thought the Baron would stoop to hiring a monster slayer. Though I hear you're good at tracking things down.
Glad you know who I am. Haven't introduced yourself, though.
Gradin, witch hunter in the service of His Royal Majesty Radovid of Redania. I'm certain you've heard of us.
Rings a bell.
If the Bloody Baron sent you to fetch his daughter, you'd best face it. You will fail in your task.
I appreciate your concern, but I don't need it. As for Tamara, she can make her own decisions.
noble of you. A killer for hire, abandoning his bounty for the good of another. The hunters and the Church of the Eternal Fire thank you.
So the Baron hired a witcher to find his daughter. Interesting. Where are you going to take her?
Tamara must rest. She's had a harrowing experience. When the warmth of the Eternal Fire has restored her strength, we shall see about finding her mother.
Hope you know what you're getting into.
I've never been more certain. The Eternal Fire is the best thing that could happen to me.
In that case, good luck.
Thank you for respecting my choice. Farewell.
Move it! Slow now.
Let's dance. We don't serve lushes, shavers, caretakers, or students from Philosopher's Hall.
Do I look like any of the people from that list?
Doesn't hurt to check, just so it's clear how things stand.
So what did they do to you, the students from...
Rather not talk on it, all right. What's your poison?
Mind if I have a look? Went?
Not with just anybody, and always for high stakes. With you, I might.
Know what? We'll play later.
A witcher. Something tells me I'll finally get something interesting to do.
Sure doesn't look like you're short on work.
So, this. A Redanian army order. But there's no pleasure in't. One after the other, same thing time and again. No finesse required.
Looking to perfect your craft?
Of course. Crafting's like ploughing a maid. Fall into a rut and... Well, sure, you'll get the job done, but there'll be no hoops, no hollers, no standing ovation. So, got any special requests for me? Help me stay on form?
Still talking about armor, aren't we?
Aye. What else would it be?
Show me what you have in stock. You're in luck. I actually do have a special order for you.
Oh, that's fantastic. Mark my words, you'll be satisfied.
Thank you. So long.
To me!
Stabbing pain here, under my belt since yesterday.
A proposed hypericum perforatum used, known also as goatweed. They help with crabs clean the
place. Everyone to me! To me!
Did you learn for a stonekeeper?
For the war I lectured at botany at the academy. Will that be all?
Come on. Run, Roach. giddy up.
Run! Leg it!
Huh? What do you want?
Hear about the notice? Got monster trouble?
Trouble? Good one. We're not having trouble. We're up shit fucking creek. Some shaggy fuck knows what's sitting in the woods attacking every Plymouth transport that dares take the high road. We're near out of bolts, arrows, rations, all around. Fucked. Sent a patrol out. Lokes never came back. So the job's simple. Bring me the fucker's head, and I'll give you gold. As much as the notice says. I'm not gonna haggle. Quartermaster won't budge. But I can throw in a pass that'll get you across the Pontar. So, deal?
Sounds fair. See what I can do. Right at the skin. Looted bare. Either someone stole the cargo after the monster attack, or our monster collects military paraphernalia. Clawed and gnawed. Necrophages fed here. But all the wounds they inflicted are post-mortem. Clawed and gnawed. Necrophages fed here. But all the wounds they inflicted are post-mortem. Clawed and gnawed. Necrophages fed here. But all the wounds they inflicted are post-mortem. Footprints. A survivor? Either that or the monster's a humanoid. Something's fishy here. I should follow these tracks. Some.
Hey!
One step more and you'll gain a new hole in your head, Dwan. What do you seek here? Speak!
Need to talk to your commander. It's important.
I don't trust you.
Figured as much when I saw your bow aimed at me. Still have me in your sight. And I'm just not prone to doing stupid things. I can assure you of that.
I'll be assured when you hand me your weapons. Come on, your swords! Drop them, and I'll take you to Vanossiel.
Fine. Lead the way.
That gurn. Strange. No monsters trouble us.
Might not trouble you, but the Redanians are convinced something prowls these woods. Hired me to kill it.
Well, they're mistaken. It's not the first time. There's no monster here. Your work is done.
This isn't a game. Men have died.
Soldiers have died. Radovid soldiers, serving the man who torments the Enshay from the Great Sea to the Blue Mountains. Soldiers who joined in massacres, tortured our brothers, raped our sisters. I shan't cry for them. And we'll not stop attacking those transports. We must eat, same as you. So you've a choice. Leave now and forget what you've seen, or die.
Do what you will. I'm not about to get involved.
Give him his things, and toss in something for those transports. Wise decisions should be rewarded. Vafail.
Run, Roach.
Come out. I'm not gonna hurt you. When did you last eat?
A week back. Half a charred squirrel and a handful of berries.
are you out here alone? Where are your parents?
Blackens killed some of them. Others kicked us out themselves. Too many mouths to feed, they said.
Here. Be sure to share it with the others.
Thank you. Here, for you. For your kindness.
Like me kitty cats.
Roasted a dog. Must have been pretty darn hungry. Hey there.
Find them, Chigrin. Interest you in a pass. Cheapest around. Right here.
What kind of pass are we talking about?
You don't know. Redanians hold all the fords across the Pontar. Can't get through without a pass. But you're in luck. So happens I've got a few to sell.
What? Could dress up like Radovid and buy a gilded carriage for that much.
What am I to do if you can't afford it?
No deal.
Whoa, hold up. Might have a little work for you. Reduce the price for a job well done, eh?
What kind of work?
Nearby. Just to the southeast. My sister's husband's got a business. He and some lads tidy up battlefields. Problem is, there's always swarms of shite bothering them. You know, them monsters drawn to corpses. Give them some protection, and I'll swing you one beautiful discount.
I think you'll swing me a discount just because.
Aye. Good idea. Discount's yours, my friend.
Better.
Pleasure doing business with you. On your way, go on now. It's scaring the other patrons off. Transit passes until we
get to you. You're a man well traveled.
So you just killed another wench.
Let it go.
You're back, finally.
Did you get the beast?
No beast to speak of in the woods. Just elves from a Squire's hell band that attacked the convoys. Here. They're squirrel tails.
Squire tell you, say? And I thought we'd exterminated the last of those vermin. And the non-humans left had wised up. Well, seems we'll need to pacify them again. Make a list of all the long ears around and hang every tenth one. That should do it.
Yeah, definitely.
I see you're of a mind on this. You're a good man. Here. The gold I promised you, and the pass. Good luck.
Maybe not. Maybe not. Maybe.
Faster.
Mug went in the kitchen, stole a hunk of meat.
Cook gave him a licking, strung him by his feet.
Cook then bled him empty, stripped his skin off clean.
Laughed and said how tasty, best sausage I have seen.
Cook's a stupid killer, shouldn't have ate the pup.
Now we'll light a fire, gonna roast him up.
1, 2, 3, the one to fetch the kindlings, thee!
Interesting rhyme.
Don't know you, go away.
What are you doing out here alone?
We's not alone. We's with Gran.
But where did you all come from?
We's orphans.
All of you?
There's a war, so there's orphans. Didn't know that.
I'm looking for the witches of Crookback Bog.
You look like a witch yourself.
The witches of the bog.
We can't go in the bog. Gran don't let us.
When my brother Zemek went missing, Gran said it was because he went in the woods and got lost. Gran cried an awful lot after that.
You could still come back.
A young woman got lost in the swamp. She has ashen hair and a scar on her face. You kids see anyone like that?
Ain't no lassies here.
What am I?
You're no lassie. Lassies got tits.
They do. Heard an old man say once, when the army was here, he says, hide them lasses in the woods. They's dazzling the soldiers with their tits. And it's torturing the poor lads. That's what he said.
Anyone else here, besides you?
Meaning who?
Someone who might have seen the woman.
Like the six-eyed tree?
Tree slapped all year. But there is Johnny.
What's this talk? What kind of jabbering is this, eh? No one allowed here. Just kids. My kids. They're allowed. But who are you, wearing swords like a bandit?
You look after these kids?
They're my grandchildren.
Gran's good to us. Gonna be soup with scratchings for supper.
Kids get lost in the woods. I miss them. Seen them in the woods? No one has.
Just talking to the kids. Asked them if they'd seen a young woman.
Oh, I was a lovely young woman. Wore a long, beautiful braid my mummy did up for me. Had dresses with flowers on them.
Maybe you've seen her. Young, ashen hair.
Your betrothed?
Daughter, actually.
Daughter? My dear, sweet little daughter and her sister. Where are they now? Maybe they've come to some harm?
Had about enough of this. Asked a simple question. You seen the woman or haven't you?
Fear not, children.
There's nought to fear, Gran. He's only angry because he cares.
Maybe Johnny knows something. I'll take him to Johnny before he goes barmy on us.
Johnny's your invention, and you shouldn't be using those ugly words. To the hut. Go on now. You'll stand in the corner, I'll make sure you do. And you, stop scaring the little ones. Now go. Be gone. Can't come in here. Not allowed in here.
I just want to talk to the boy.
Not allowed. It's not allowed.
He won't talk to you anyway. Gran don't like you. And Johnny's made up. And strangers steal kids.
Just tell me where I can find Johnny.
Johnny's made up.
Be gone. Be gone! What is this? What? Nothing for you here.
Wonder where he's
Stay
from.
Away from the kids.
Why don't you want to talk about Johnny? One of you knows about him. The others must too.
It's just him who's pals with Johnny. They pick mushrooms and hunt snails. But Gran says Johnny's made up.
Have any of you ever seen Johnny?
Of course. Looks just like him.
Then why do you say he's made up?
Gran says so. And Gran knows lots.
Does your Gran treat you right? She ever hurt you?
Never.
When we're bad, she cries.
She's scared. Says strangers might take us, and we'll disappear.
The boy who plays with Johnny, he must be brave.
Not brave, just stupid.
Sat his bare bum on an anthill once. But yeah, he plays with Johnny. He don't listen to Gran and goes in the woods, and then he's got to have a time out.
And he eats snails. Yuck.
The girl I mentioned is in danger. You gotta help me get your Gran away from the hut so I can talk to Johnny's friend.
All right, but you gotta do something for us too. Play hide and seek. Gran never does. Says her feet hurt.
Let's play. You hide, but if I find you, you have to help me talk to the boy who knows Johnny.
He thinks he'll find us easy.
Means he's never hid from the black ones.
No looking, and you have to count out loud. All your fingers, toes, too.
One, two, three, 18, 19, 20. Ready or not, here I come. There you are.
How'd you find me?
See you. Come out. I can see you.
Not fair. I'm supposed to win.